Okay, Riley, let's draft some Ravnica Allegiance.
Let's do it.
You feel like the Hallowed Fountain is of no value to you because you already have all four, right?
I already got all four. Don't need it. Don't want it.
That has 20 gems written all over it then, buddy.
Yeah, no, don't want it. Don't need it. Don't want those gems. You want to take that card? I think Lore Mage's Binding is very good.
I think that's the pick here, yeah. It's awkward because this is very good and this is very good, but...
Well, let's just check. Let's just see what Frank Karsten thinks. Well, we've got an entire pick list available from him on ChannelFireball.com.
Oh, we do, Riley? Well, let's pull it up.
All right, I've got it right in front of me. So Lore Mage's Binding has an aggregate of 3.5, but the Sphinx of New Prague comes in at... Ooh, that is a surprising 4.47. So let's snag that Sphinx.
We're going to go with the Wisdom of Frank on this one?
Do you know what we should do? We should just use the pick order list to make all of our decisions.
Let's just go full pick order list.
Yep.
Start to finish. Okay, so is that higher than Windstorm Drake?
Let me check. Windstorm Drake comes in at a paltry 3.34, Dennis.
So it is the Sphinx.
Yep, I'll just check Sunder Shaman. Get out of here, 3.28. Nah, Sphinx of New Prague, easy game. All right, next one. So we've got Azorius Knight Arbiter at 2.5. Let me have a look at Gateway Sneak. Gateway Sneak is... Oh, this is a Gateway Plaza. That's not where I'm interested. Gateway Sneak is 2.87, so that's winning at the moment.
That's winning at the moment, yeah.
All right. What about Arrestor's Admonition?
I don't think Arrestor's Admonition holds a candle to the Gateway Sneak.
2.61. No, that's true. Oh, Scuttlegator, though. 1.7. Forget it.
So it's the Sneak.
Looks like it's the Sneak. Looks like we're sneaking through those gateways, Dennis.
Okay. Okay, for this one... See, nah, that doesn't actually make sense. So what do you think here? The Flicker? I'm a big fan of Flicker effects, personally speaking.
Well, it's only 1.59, so I can't say the good doctor agrees with you.
The good doctor, Frank Karsten.
Would you like to know how much Deface is?
How much is Deface?
0.6.
I mean, this card's like unabashedly awful, that's why.
Doesn't even get a point across point. It doesn't even get into single
whole
digits.
Numbers, yeah.
Yeah. Cavalcade of Calamity does. It's a 1.
Right.
Man, this is a real stinker.
Well, this is a stinker for Azorius cards. So do we just take, like, a Guildgate? Or in this case, do we just go raw numbers and pick whatever Frank says?
Yeah, I don't mind that at all. All right, so what's that going to... What's going to be the highest one here? I'm going through...
I don't know.
Whoa. Man, it is hard to type with one hand. Undercity Scavenger comes in at 2.35. That's not that good. Debtor's Transport 1.6. No, also a stinker.
What about the Wrecking Beast?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at. Wrecking Beast is just a 2.
That's the best we have so far, isn't it?
Gift of Strength 1.9. Man, this is not looking good. Simic Guildgate.
Why has the Guildgate come in?
Simic Guildgate is 2.5. I think we are taking the Simic Guildgate.
All right.
I love it.
Okay, how about the Senate Griffin?
All right, Senate Griffin. Senate Courier is 2.3. That's not what we want. Senate Griffin comes in at a very respectable 3.12.
That's pretty good. I'm happy to take that.
All right. Bring to Trial 2.3. Not interested in that. The Prowling Caracal, I'm sure, is not... 1.17.
No, I'm happy with the Senate Griffin. Oh, now. What about the Sphinx of the Guild Pact?
Let's have a look at the Sphinx of the Guild Pact. It comes in at 2.98, so it's actually a reasonably good rate.
Strong at the gate. What about the Impassioned Orator?
Impassioned Orator is 2.48.
So Sphinx wins out in that exchange.
Sphinx wins out in that regard. Yeah. The locket I'll look up just for completion's sake.
For posterity's sake, yeah.
1.32.
So it is the Sphinx.
I like that Azorius, Simic, and Orzhov are 1.32, 1.28, and 1.27, respectively. And then Gruul and Rakdos, 0.93 and 0.89.
Because they're aggressive decks.
You don't want lockets in those decks. All right. Oh, we got a... What do we got? I love this card. Oh,
where does Growth Spiral come in?
I love this card so much. But Frank doesn't. 1.94.
What about the Messenger?
Concordia Pegasus is 2.10. Let's have a look at Concordia. Oh, sorry. It's Syndicate Messenger. Syndicate Messenger is a 2.7. That's a good card. 2.73.
So it's this one right here? Okay.
Yep. I'm learning so much about the format.
Sky Tether?
I don't know if we are tethering.
Strong
things.
In a Flyers deck.
Sky Tether is a 2.8. 2.83 even. Man, that's better than I thought it was. All right.
An easy pick there.
Watchful. Oh, nope. Okay, never mind. Watchful Giant 1.3. So, yeah. All right. Well, Coral Commander is not going to be very good.
No, we're going to get stuck in the Gilgate here.
Is it going to be better than Simic
Gilgate? Probably not.
Let's have a look. This is good. I'm enjoying this a lot. Coral.
I think the formula falls apart a little here towards the end of the pack, no?
No. This is where the numbers really don't lie, Denis. All right. It's Simic Gilgate. Coral Commander is a 1.
Simic Gilgate?
Yep. Take the Gilgate.
Okay.
Yep.
If you say so.
All right, Senate Griffin again, or do we want to?
Let's check the Azorius Guildgate.
Okay, Azorius Guildgate, 1 Azorius Guildgate, sir. Also, all of the Guildgates 2.5.
Okay, what was the Senate Griffin?
One moment, please. Senate Griffin 3.12. So yeah, easy Senate Griffin.
Easy Griffin. Okay.
The
Orzhov Guildgate.
We're gonna end up with a lot of Guildgates, but I love it. Take it. You know what, Tennis? That's a freebie for you.
Ooh, dealer's choice.
Yeah.
Give me that steeple creeper. Bonus points for rhyming. Ooh, this is another steeple Gilgate, creeper. I think.
Yeah. This is nice. I'm enjoying the...
Now, what about the Twilight Panther versus the Simic Locket?
I'm enjoying the flexibility here. Twilight Panther is 1.83. And the Locket, the Simic Locket, is 1.28.
So it's the Panther.
It's Pantherino all day, every day.
And whatever. And a second Panther,
another,
I suppose.
Oh, another little Panther.
Ooh. How do you feel about Ministrant of Obligation?
I love how it's not a minister, a ministrant. All right,
or the Swirling Torrent.
Ministrant, 3.55.
Mm-hmm. Torrent.
And Swirling, 2.92.
So the Ministrant wins out?
The Ministrant wins out by a fair margin, by 0.7.
Decent margin, okay. Okay, well, we have to listen to Frank on this one.
We have to listen to Frank. No, we are building the perfect deck, according to Dr. Frank. Rally to Battle?
Yeah.
2.08, no good.
What about the Savant?
2.33, that's our winner so far. The Portal is no good, we've already checked, that's like a 1 point something.
What's the Gilgate baseline again?
2.5.
Okay. Is that wait, what was the Savant?
2.3.
So the Gilgate wins?
The Gilgate wins. Do we just have to take the Gilgate?
Whoa. That's it. What about the Galloping Lizrog?
Okay, let's have a look at the Lizrog. Wait, it is the Lizrog. 2.69. Nice.
Okay, what about Applied Biomancy?
I love how, you know, the nerds over in pure biomancy are being completely upscaled by the people in applied biomancy. This is where the real work gets done. 2.63.
That's above the Gilgate baseline.
Yeah, the Gilgate baseline.
What about Basilica Bellhaunt, which is impossible to cast.
Basilica Bellhaunt, 2.91, so not even that higher, not much higher.
What about Summary Judgment?
It's got to be good, right? 3.07.
Perfect.
We found
a nice,
we got a
neat
ding.
3.
Got a winner.
Skittereel. It's a card I like quite a lot.
It doesn't make any sense. How can an eel skitter?
It's got legs. What are you talking about?
Yeah, but then it's no longer an eel.
Simic would disagree.
2.67. That's looking good.
Barely eeks out over the Simic Gilgate, though.
I don't think we're going to beat like Exposed to Daylight, are we? Forget it. Sorry, that was not the card that I thought it was. Sorry.
Right, okay.
That was the target creature with 3 power or something. Anyway, doesn't matter. Skittereel.
You think? Okay.
Yeah.
Ooh, High Alert.
High Alert. I love this card. A little sneak preview for our viewers here. You may be seeing High Alert played on a certain Arena Boys video in the near future here.
Mm.
Bring to Trial is what I was thinking of. Which is a 2.3.
What about the High Alert, though?
High Alert is 2.15. Give us a look at our... Let's have a look at the creatures that we've got.
Let me just adjust my camera slightly. Boom, 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 boom. That should be a little bit better. No.
What are we looking at here? Because I don't think we've got a lot of big booty, a lot of...
No, but, you know, making a 2-3 into a 3-3 is pretty good, too, though.
Mm-hmm. But I mean, do we have any other fat bottom girls, or is that it?
Fat bottom girls. Oh god. Oh god. Technical difficulties. So High Alert strictly downgrades this.
Yep.
Upgrades this. Yep. This is a wash. Downgrades this.
Downgrade. I think. Downgrades this. I don't think we're on high alert. I think we can chill out and just the alert's over. It's time to bring them to trial, Denis. Time to do justice.
It's time to I love this card.
All right, let's see.
Let's put Bring to Trial and Arrestor's Admonition in the Frank Karsten Arena. Frank Karsten Pick Order Arena.
We need like some beep boop sound effects here. Admonition is 2.61. Mm-hmm. Bring to Trial 2.36. Yes, yeah, so the admonition has it.
Absolutely. Ooh, Sentinel's Mark. Ooh, Fairy Jewelist is a card I'm quite fond of as well, though.
Sentinel's Mark 2.95. Very, very powerful. Fairy Jewelist 2.57. Also very good.
Syndicate Messenger, what was that? Surely it wasn't over 3.
So at the moment, the Sentinel's Mark is winning 2.7. So man, we got a good little pack here.
Good little mark. Okay.
Right.
What wins? Is it the Syndicate Messenger, the Syndicate Griffin, the Senate Griffin, the Syndicate Messenger, or the Viscopa Vampire?
So the Messenger 2.7, the Griffin is 3.12. So the Messenger is the Griffin is winning so far. Let's have a look at the Vampo here. 2.97. Now another good pack. Well, let's take the Griffin. So,
are we trusting the numbers or are we trusting the fact that we need 3 drops?
I think we're trusting the numbers.
I appreciate that. I appreciate the dedication to the craft. Yep. All right. What is the breakdown between Slimebind and Impassioned Orator?
Slimebind is a very solid 2.56 and the Orator is 2.48. It is, there is just a ball hair in it, Denis.
I misheard. Who comes out on top?
The Impassioned Orator is below the Slimebind. The Slimebind wins. I said that in a really weird way, but the Slimebind ultimately wins
by
the tiniest of margins.
Ooh, the Tarrant's got to be high, though. Swirling
That's
got to
be good, right? That's got to be good. We're going to swirl our way right into that pick. Is that at 2.92?
And that must be the Hazard Officer.
Hazard Officer, 1.8. Get out of here, my friend. Back to boot camp with you.
Okay. Ooh, the Gilgate. Does Rally to Battle or just a Shears Portal beat a 2.5 Gilgate?
It does not.
Get in. What about... I mean, it's just a Locket probably, right? We can't cast any of the cards.
Yeah. All right, yeah. Yep.
Okay, the Panther or Exposed to Daylight?
We shouldn't... We're playing best... Oh, no, we're playing best of 3, aren't we? So probably take Exposed to Daylight.
Okay. Gotta run these.
Oh, just in case. Actually, that Cry of the Carnarium would have been useful, but never mind.
Okay. Oof, well, this is a stinker of a pack.
This is a real stinker. This is a real stinker. So we got a Slimebind. That's already... We know that that's like a reasonable pick. What about the Zeal? Arrested Zeal 2.2. It's
How?
Not... Well, it's
that
a,
seems
it's a
crazy.
Cheap... Why?
Yeah, that should be higher.
Oh, right. You think it's... Okay, you think it's not as good. All right. The other thing is Final Payment is 2.99. Just a bargain at 2.99, Denis.
2.99. I suppose we have to take it. We do have some Gilgates.
Yeah, we've got one. We got one.
Oh, no. I'm making an executive decision on taking the Arrestor's.
Yeah, I think so too. Yeah. I mean, this is where this kind of falls apart a little bit, which I'm not, you know, it's obviously the numbers never lie, it's perfect, but this is all pack one, pick one situation.
Of course, we're not using this quite as intended, but that being said, we're going to pick about 4 playset of Senate Griffins here, I think.
Yep.
Adding to our
I like we're getting to the point now where we don't need to use the thing because we're not so well. All right, so we've got an Aeromunculus.
Interesting.
It's 2.7. Is that better than the Skitterial? 2.6. Oh, that's close.
What about the 10th District Veteran? Surely it's better than that. That's worse.
No, it's worse. 1.9. So the Skitterial just beats out the Aeromunculus. Oh, sorry. No, other way around.
Yeah, Aeromunculus wins out, right?
All right. Let's take it.
Rowdy, we can't cast any of these green cards.
Why? What are you talking about? We've got 2 Kissimmee Guildgates.
We're splashing such bad cards. Okay.
Nah, it's fine. Ooh. It's perfect.
Where does Repudiate Replicate fit in?
Repudiate is a 3.09.
What about Growth Spiral?
Beating out Fairy Duel. Man, Growth Spiral is so good. I love that card. I love everything about that card. The art, everything. 1.94. I don't love the rating.
Fairy Duelist doesn't beat it, obviously. Archway Angel? Sure, that's a no-go.
One moment, please. 2.55.
So it's the Repudiate.
It's the Repudiate.
Okay. All right.
It's going really well here. I love this. I love this 3-color nonsense we have.
What about Prying Eyes?
Just to really push up our curve a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
1.5.
We can't take a 5th Griffin, man.
No, that would be against the rules. It's just the fairy duelist.
Okay, let's just take the duelist. Ooh, okay. What about Civic Stalwart?
When I think of a civic stalwart, I don't think of an elephant like with a sword. I think of, you know, someone who goes to town hall meetings and, you know, makes and picks up other people's rubbish at the park. 2.49.
2.49. That comes in below an Osorius Guildgate, Riley.
Do we need another 4-drop? Probably not, right?
No. Let's just take the Guildgate, I guess.
All Guildgates all day.
Okay, here we go.
All right.
Where does Skatewing Spy come in?
Gotta be good, right?
Mm-hmm.
3.46. Oh, that is what is known in the business as a slam dunk pick.
Let's add that to our ever-growing list. Oh, Riley, the Frilled Mystic, though.
We might have to take that just because I need it. It is an uncommon. I do have 1,000 uncommon wild cards. Don't worry about it. We can.
Have 126 uncommon wild cards.
Right? I'll burn it. I'll burn an uncommon wild card and a Frilled Mystic at one point. I guess Arrest of Zeal?
Riley, what is the rating on the Frilled Mystic?
Oh, excuse me. 3.09.
It's high. I think we have to take it.
All right, let's take it.
We're never casting it.
We're playing straight three colors. This is great.
We've minimal fixing. Let's take the only card that's in our colors here, which is a fog, unfortunately.
Fixing is for cowards, mate.
Let's take the Watchful Giant, I suppose.
Okay. Yep.
The Locket, sure, I'll play that.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. The Growth Spiral, I'll play that.
Sure.
Frank was not a fan of this card, no?
Nope, he didn't like it.
Okay. Oh, Watchdog Wield.
Oh, wow.
Okay. We have 8 cuts to make.
Okay.
We have a cool... Look at that big, fat 4-drop stack.
Yeah, we are. We're not going to have any problems playing 4-drops here.
Oh, you're breaking up on me.
Yeah, sorry. No, that's just... I've got a really loose connection to my XLR cable. It's very frustrating. I do apologize for the intermittent audio issues here.
We could probably lose one of these Griffins at least. Probably lose this Galloping Lizrog. Possibly lose the Sphinx the Guild Pact.
Mm-hmm. The Prying Eyes is
fine.
And what's the Watchful Giant?
Meh, you're right. What about the Frilled Mystic? Is it just uncastable?
Oh, we're just never casting it.
We could have played many a Griffin, but I think 3 is actually the number we want.
Do we even want to play green?
No.
Probably not. You've still got a Steeple Creeper.
That card's not very good, though.
No, but it's in the deck.
Oh gosh, you're right.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's not that great. It's not that great.
The Locket's fine, and then we just play yet another Senate Griffin.
This card will get it done for us.
And then also the Watchful Giant.
Sure. What else have we got? Is that it?
That's it. That's the only blue and white cards we have left.
Yeah.
This is a cool. Wait, hang on. This is 43. Oh, it's because it didn't remove these. That's fine. Wait, that's okay. So there, that's 40. And says that's 40 and 17 lands there.
Nice. All right.
Sorry, that's actually only 16 lands, but with a Locket. Let's just cut the Locket and play an extra land then.
All right.
Okay, deck's perfect. Can't lose.
Oh wait, hang on. Whoa. We're playing Resolute Watchdog.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
Also, we're playing Twilight Panther as a 1/2.
That we can't. We can put a Guildgate in.
Yeah, put an Orzhov Guildgate. Yeah.
There we go. Sorry. Mild oversight on my part.
This is really good.
Frank's not going to fail us, mate. We took it into a competitive draft queue, and it's going to be all right.
Yep.
Oh, boy. It's going to be a brief stream.
How can we possibly lose, Denis? We've got the power of numbers on our side.
That's true. Magic is a game of numbers, and we got Frankie Magic numbers to back us up.
I think it was Ben Stark. I'm not sure who I was talking to. Someone was saying that they would prefer
Perfect.
Magic if it were just... Yeah, this is great. If it were just numbers.
That's Ben Stark, yeah. Do we mulligan this? Probably, right?
No, keep it. Keep it.
Okay, cool.
What could go wrong?
What could go wrong?
As in, you know, if it was just cards like...
Hey, look at that! Get that 1/2 out there. Get that Squire.
You know, if it was just card like, I play card, 347-FA.
Yeah, just serial numbers.
Yeah, that would be much better.
Riley, look at this.
Yeah, it looks great. You want a summary judgment? I do.
It's nice to have the option.
We're curving out ferociously here. This is looking pretty good. So what's the addendum on summary judgment again?
It deals 5 instead.
Mm-hmm.
That's problematic. Oh boy, okay, well, strap in. Come at me. Inexplicably, play a land and pay 4 to jump this.
Yep. Our opponent also won 3 color nonsense by the look of things.
Yeah, I mean...
Well, not that we are, actually. The wheels kind of fell off our 3 color.
Pow.
Get that out of here, mate.
Don't pump it. That's against the rules.
Yeah, it's always dangerous. They start looking at the cards in their hand. They start hovering over it.
Tower defense.
Ooh.
No blocks.
All right. Okay.
Joke's on them. We get to swing back now.
Get in there. Just get in there, mate.
Do we trade here? Probably just sky tether this, right? And then it's whatever.
Yeah. It's a pretty good defender, though. It trades up a long way.
Not when this is flying, it doesn't.
Yeah, that's true. All right. Let's take 4. We're unafraid.
Ooh.
Well, I'm unafraid anyway.
Yeah, I was going to say, you got somewhere to be? You want to get out of here fast? What's going on?
Nah, man. No, it is. It's 7:30 in the morning. And as I was saying to you before, despite the fact that it is 7:30, it is 31 degrees, which is... What is that?
Toasty.
What is that in fake degrees? Let me see.
31 degrees is 31 Celsius.
Yeah, so it's 87 or 89. Oh, 80, sorry,
Riley, 80, we got the combo.
Easy. This game's so easy. We can activate it. We can activate it, not this turn, but the next turn.
Yeah, right on time. No, stop.
Right on time.
Okay, cool. Let's tether this so we don't die to it, I guess.
Yep.
Slam that Orzhov Gilgate down to show we mean business. Come on.
And then
we
got... we got so many 6 drops as well to resolve. It's really good.
Oh, stop. We got our deck's nothing but... All right.
Anyway, overnight, it got as low as 27, 80 Ooh, degrees.
Chilly 80 degrees in the middle of the night?
It was chilly. Yesterday was one of the hottest days on record. It got as high as 118. It got to 48 degrees.
Oh boy.
Yeah. Yeah. I was in an air conditioned car for most of it. I was driving home from Adelaide, but, she was a warm one, Dennis.
We need to put the screws in our opponent here. They just played a Rhythm of the Wild.
Okay. That's fine. Let's play Watchful Giant.
Yeah. This is the Rhythm of the Wild. I'm a silly, forgetful boy, really.
You can't adapt. Can you adapt? No, it doesn't even matter now because you've actually blocked. All right, that's fine.
I can adapt and we'll just eat it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we'll do that then.
Just wasn't planning on doing that with my turn as well.
No. But you know what? It's better to make 2 mistakes that everyone sees rather than 1 that only you know about.
That's not true. You got that wrong.
No, it's backwards. That's 100. No, it's better to make 2 mistakes that everyone sees. No, wait. No, it's not. Yeah, it's better to make 1 mistake that everyone sees rather than 2 that only you know about.
There's a Palo article about that on ChannelFireball.com, isn't there?
That's where I got it from, but I got it wrong. That's why, that's why I'm not a member of the NPL.
You know what you just did, Riley? You made 1 mistake that everybody saw.
I did too. Oh, man. I made a big fool of myself.
Is this coming in as a 5-2 or is it staying as a 6-3? 6-3, greedy. Well, that has Death Touch written all over it, mate.
Yeah, that's just
slam down the Watchful Giant and beat down in the air.
I agree. I think this is a great approach to take, and that Panther is finally going to do some work here.
I've just done 3 damage, thank you very much. Wow, or more.
I don't know. It's not really justifying its position on the payroll just yet. It's taking a lot of coffee breaks, you know. It's spending a lot of time around the water cooler.
What is this? What fresh hell is this?
What fresh hell is this? What Rhythm of the Wild inspired hell is this?
This is the rhythm of the... This guy's just taking a bunch of boars for a stroll down the side of the street. What the hell is that about?
They don't seem particularly wild. Like, it seems like a very orderly...
Oh god, there's a lot of them. I didn't even realize.
Porcine parade.
Look how many there are.
Yeah.
This is a porcine stampede.
Do you reckon the pig that Domri is riding...
That stings.
...is happy... to be ridden.
This one, this little fella right here.
like, do you think that pig is like, yes, the boss is on my back, chose my back rather than anyone else?
In a Rudolph kind of way, I think so.
Or is it kind of like, ugh, this again?
I'm just going to play this. You know what? I'm going to offer the trade for this guy. You know what? Let's...
Really?
Yeah.
Seems bold.
You got a panther to hang back. If you want to do this, I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it.
All right. I just think that they're just never attacking with the 6-3 because of our little pantherino here. But we can get some work done with the Syndicate Messenger.
Yeah. Wow. 5-3 o'clock, yeah. Baby.
Drawing that Oz of Guildgate was so good. We've got panther activations for days.
Well, we can only activate one, which is awkward.
That's fine. Don't worry about it. What gives the Twilight Panther death touch? Like, what is the flavor behind that? Because usually giving a creature death touch is almost always a poisonous ability.
It's poisonous, yeah. This thing can hunt ghosts, which gives it death touch somehow. Yeah, that connection's lost on me a little bit, I guess.
Yeah, the flavor kind of falls apart. Like, they could have made a Twilight Spider or something. I guess then it has to have reach. I don't know.
This guy does not have any gravel on him.
No, gravel hide. He's bum.
Oh, I see. Okay.
It's all over his butt.
Tastefully left out of shot in this game.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, come on. There are children who play this game, Dennis.
Everyone's not really doing an awful lot.
Not really doing an awful lot, no. I mean, you can get pumped, but that doesn't do anything against our mighty
Twilight Panthers. In we go. Yeah.
Definitely don't play the land here.
Yeah.
Oh, Fearless. Fearless. I love it. You're so aggressive. I love it. I love the aggression.
I want to win. I want to get this down to zero.
Yeah, you're busy. You're busy, man. You got things to do. You got places to go. Absolutely. People to see.
Jokes. I knew we've drawn the only black source in our entire deck.
No, they reread it.
Mm-hmm.
They reread it like, oh, how lucky can they be?
Oh.
See, I really like Rhythm of the Wild. I think it's a very good card.
It is a very good card.
But it doesn't seem to be doing all that much work in this situation.
Well, our opponents played Rhythm of the Wild and played one creature a turn, and they haven't been big ones.
Yeah.
Like, this is big, but Fred, is this just happening?
Well, did we do really well with the Twilight Panther draw to, you know, turn off the 6-3 and that sort of thing?
I do this main phase, Riley, so that it can get countered.
Yes, very smart.
I did it in case we drew a Guildgate, so we could play the damn Guildgate.
Man, and now Frilled Mystic here to blow us out.
Oh, man, he made me look a right mug.
That was not great. Kind of gave him a free a free 4/4 drop there. Youch. Oh well.
You know what we need here? That Sentinel's thing.
Sentinel Totem.
Not Sentinel Totem. No, not Sentinel Totem.
On the XL the graveyard.
No, Sentinel. I'm good.
Sentinel's really mark.
We really need Relic of Progenitus here. That's what I'm hoping for. Yep. Rip off the top. Here it comes.
It wouldn't be too bad.
It'd be pretty bad, because it would replace itself.
We'll say it cycles for 2 mana. It's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Better than a bloody Sentinel Totem. That you were going on about drawing a Sentinel Totem, Dennis.
That's true. That is on me.
Yeah, that one's on you, my friend.
What's happening? Reinventing the wheel over here, reading all our cards again.
Yeah, looking at the Soldier Token, being like, what does this card do?
Spike. Okay. I was trying to just kill us. Giving that bad boy haste. All right, well, I will jump here. Or do I just go to... Will we just go to 3?
Go to 3 and get skewered.
That's true.
Doesn't seem good. All right, down to 8. This is okay. We can come back from this.
Nice.
Oh, yes. All right. I feel like we did want another body here, but...
This is okay. This lets this eat this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think we can attack, can we?
No, we can't.
All right. Well, our opponent probably thinks we're going to Panther the Mystic.
Well, we'll probably Panther this.
Yeah, I know, but they're going, oh, we can attack in this way, and they'll block in that way, and we're gonna zag on them here. All right. Yep. Good.
I'm trying to do this as fast as possible so as to dazzle our opponent.
Yes,
it worked.
Very good. Yeah. Just let it happen.
Looking at that combat trick in their hand, being like, what? It all happened so fast. I couldn't possibly keep up. Please have nothing in your hand. If they have nothing in their hand, we have a shot here.
Yeah, if they're holding 3 reverse artist proofs, we're fine.
Ooh.
Oh, no.
I don't know why they didn't just play that and give it haste, to be totally honest.
Yeah, that seems a little better. Dennis, that was not a good draw.
Well, we have to attack here.
Yep, I agree. Get aggressive.
Go to one, except every creature in our opponent's deck has haste, so let's see how that goes. So,
probably die.
We're gonna...
How lucky can you be? Maybe they give it a +1/+1 counter. They did not. They saw the line.
Let's let them attack.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they saw it again. Yep. Yep.
The old magic online.
Settle the wreckage?
Yeah, settle the wreckage off the top.
Yep, just really get them.
Alright, we struggled to hit playables in our deck, so I don't think sideboarding is going to be really something we're too interested in.
Do we want the Exposed to Daylight for the Rhythm of the Wild?
I mean, they're so likely to get all their value out of the Rhythm of the Wild before we destroy it. And there's like, you really want this to hit pacifisms and stuff, right?
Are we over-teching here?
I think that's too... I don't think that's very good.
Okay, alright. Don't worry about it.
Will we live long enough to resolve this?
It's pretty good.
It's not even that good, though.
Is it not even that good? Yeah, 5/5
flies. 7 mana.
Yeah.
Nah, I think our deck's perfect, and we just...
Okay.
We got unlucky. Like, I think we win if our draw spell doesn't get countered there.
Dennis, my favorite feature of MTG colon Arena is still live. It is the fact that the avatar changes when you're logged in on multiple computers. It's so, so good.
I didn't even consult you, sorry. This hand just seemed pretty okay.
I'll take you. You know, you're a better player than I. Despite me having 100% of the pro points in this relationship.
That's true.
I defer to your wisdom.
Fight me, bro. We're on the board. First blood. Can't take that away from us no matter what.
No.
I'll flash him as a 1/2 flyer. It's fine. Yeah, let's
right.
do it.
Yeah, can you just make sure you do it before their combat? Yeah, good, good, good.
Yeah.
Do it in the first main phase.
Upkeep.
Yep. No, I'll do it at the declare blockers phase.
My favorite phase.
Do it at the end of combat step.
Ooh, can you even get to that on Arena?
I don't think you can. I think when there's no combat, it skips everything.
Yeah, but if we get into a combat, surely I can get into the end of combat phase.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Yeah, the little thing at the bottom right, it opens up.
2-1. What is this? It's kindergarten? I don't know. I'm going to tether that.
No, come on, we can do better.
Let's just offer the trade.
And I think they'll take it.
That's
crazy. They'd be wise to as well. Nice. Yeah, that's good. Because we're not guaranteed to draw the one black source.
They didn't.
No! Boo. Alright.
Let's hold off. We might bind some slime to this, we'll see. I can see a world where we bind some slime.
Yeah, I can see a very slimy world. They're gonna get slimed like Nickelodeon.
Yeah. What was up with that? There was a whole decade where Nickelodeon just threw slime at children for the general entertainment of the public, and everyone was like,
"Well, and television celebrities
and celebrities."
Like, there were some pretty big name celebrities that got slimed.
Is it still on your bucket list to like win a Kids' Choice Award? Is that still something you're interested in?
No, this was not something that was ever really on my list.
Oh, Riley!
Oh, mate. Oh, mate. Not such a savage smash, now more of a slimy smash.
Oh, boy. I mean, we just traded the slime bind for this, really, is what happened.
That's fine. That's good.
It also makes this a non-blocker.
Yeah, now the Panther can really get busy. Really start to get some lunch.
Pa-pow. All right, no 5 drop, my favorite kind of turn.
Man, I'm now looking at stack of fours. I'm looking at pictures of Justin Bieber and Joe Jonas. No, Nick Jonas. I can't tell. One of the Jonases. And Will Smith covered in green slime. This is not how I thought my morning was going to go.
Yeah, it's very early for you to be looking at slimy pictures of Justin Bieber on the internet.
I know. That normally doesn't kick in until after lunch.
Yeah, yeah. Ooh, this has a sky tether written all over it, mate. We get the fun interaction between defender and attacks each combat available.
Yeah, yeah, nice, yeah.
Need to be sure not to attack the kitty into danger here.
Now prying eyes. Seems decent.
Alright, 13 turn clock here.
Yep. Little fairy duelist. Oh, there it is.
The rhythm of the wild.
We're gonna get that every time.
The song? Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. All of the.
The steeple of the creeper. The creeper. Oh yeah.
My only concern is all of the, all of the sweet sweet payments we're getting from this video. All of the tips, the bits, the ad money. It's going straight. No, it's just going straight to Corona.
Yeah.
Royalty payments in the back pocket. All right.
Got some spicy cards in our hand here.
Yeah, we got some real spice cooking.
The steeple creeper's gonna take a good old scuttle up our steeple and put the screws to us, though, I think.
Gonna creep up a steeple. Creeple steeple. What manner of creature is this? A frog snake.
That's just snake legs, really.
It doesn't look very frog-like, I have to say.
I mean, it's got feet.
Okay, can I point this out to you, Dennis? Neither a frog nor a snake has claws.
Yes. True.
I don't know where the Simic... I think the Simic are very loose in their estimation of what creatures or what animals are and or do.
Mm-hmm. They're liberal with their naming, yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah.
Ooh, a hasty boy, huh?
All right. This guy's very good.
Right, haste, right. I mean, take eight, I guess.
That's fine. That's
not
fine.
Great.
We've got a good blocker coming down next turn.
In the Watchful Giant.
Mm-hmm.
Keeping an eye on things for us. Oh, no!
Oh, fairy duelist. Its dueling days are over.
Yeah.
Well, at least we have the Resolute Watchdog, Dennis.
No one can take that away from us.
Well, I mean, technically. the old bloody the nasty boys from the pound come by.
Oh, true, yeah.
He's a good dog, though.
He's a good dog.
He's a little good dog. Good little dog.
A friend in good times. A guardian in bad times. And a savior when all else fails.
That's a lot on the docket for that dog. That's a long job description for a dog.
Yeah, it's a lot to expect from a little pupper, isn't it?
Yeah, it is indeed. How resolute is this watchdog?
I mean, clearly enough to die for his owner in this case, right?
Yeah, it looks like it. Is our Sphinx going to help us out here, Dennis?
No, it just trades for the rubble slinger, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Ooh, steeple creeper.
Taking to the skies.
Mm-hmm.
Not great.
We'll need something that is not...
Syndicate Messenger. You don't want to cast the Sphinx?
And I just trade it for the Steeple Creeper?
It doesn't do much, does it?
Well, I mean, we actually trade it for the Resolute Watchdogs that we do there.
Oh, that seems reasonable.
Mm.
Yeah, good little boy. Flying on the sky. Flying on the back of this Hippogriff. Mate, it's just Sirius Black.
Oh my gosh, you're right.
It is just Sirius Black.
It really is. Well, it really is. Because you said Hippogriff.
Well, that looks a lot like a Hippogriff.
It does look a lot like a Hippogriff. This is not really a Sphinx. Sphinxes don't fly in ordinary Egyptian mythology, do they?
This Sphinx has been hitting it so hard on the vertical lat machine. By the way. Look at those shoulders.
Look at the shoulders, muscles on that bad boy.
She is so buff. All right. Man, our aerial superiority isn't even assured because of this stupid rubble slinger.
Our aerial superiority is far from assured.
Because red now has reach creatures. Or reaches.
This is a green-red card, to be fair.
Oh, see. The old colorblindness getting me once again.
Yeah?
Didn't realize that was a hybrid card there. Do you know how I checked?
How's that?
The texture behind the picture on the right hand on the left hand side.
Oh, it's different to this texture. Yeah.
And that was how I checked, and I didn't look at the other side because the red and the green are more or less the same.
What about the symbol though, mate?
Yeah, but that's not there. That's not there when it's zoomed out.
Oh, like so? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So I've embarrassed myself, Dennis. I've embarrassed myself.
We've had a pretty effective stalemate here.
Yeah, this is
all quiet on the Western Front.
I mean, we just need a way to clear that rubble slinger.
Nice.
An island isn't going to do it. We've already cast our prying eyes.
We can't just attack with this.
It's got vigilance. Let's get busy, Denis.
Yeah, let's do it.
We didn't come here to make friends.
We did not.
We've got enough friends. Okay, yeah. Opponent, reading all their cards. Oh, yeah, it's interesting.
And this one, just double-checking that one again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let me have a look at that.
Go, dog, go! Leap 30 feet into the air and save that Sphinx.
Save that Sphinx. Save those sweet lat muscles. Yeah, man, colorblindness really has held me back a long way, Denis.
Yeah?
Can't work as a pilot.
Mm-hmm. Can't work as a bomb. Is that an ambition of yours?
As a bomb technician. Can't be a Sparky.
Can't be a spy.
A Sparky, an electrician.
You call that a Sparky? I mean, you know real words exist in the English language. You don't need to...
Yeah, well...
Oh, our opponent tried to adapt this, even though they got greedy and put a counter on it with the Rhythm of the Wild.
Yep. Yeah, it's good. It's good. I like that you can still activate the ability.
I'm going to BM and nice.
Nice. I'd like to point out that this level of BM is uncharacteristic for me.
Oh yeah, but I'm on your account, so I have carte blanche to do whatever I want.
Yeah, you've got the BM license.
Mm-hmm.
And you are waving it around.
If our opponent attacks us here with the Steeple Creeper, we'll probably just chump with a Syndicate Messenger, right?
Yep, get a little 1/1 flyer at the deal.
And then do something with that at some stage, I assume.
Little bird ghost. Nope, no attacks. Oh. Ooh.
Well, let's try exchange the griffin. Exchange this for this.
Yep. This portion of the stream brought to you by McDonald's because I'm loving it.
Nice. Very, very smooth. All right, big fat tradey boy there. You want to try this as well?
And this part of the stream was brought to you by, I think it's Subway, because right now I'm having it my way.
That's Burger King, mate.
Burger King, sorry.
Would you like to know something? Undone again by the Tower Defense.
Tower Defense absolutely got you here. That's not great.
Scries should be good.
Let me soothe your savage breast here, Denis, by giving you a Burger King fact.
What's your Burger King fact?
Burger King in Australia is not called Burger King.
What is it called?
It's called
Dingo Queen or something. Like.
No, it's called Hungry Jack's.
Excuse me?
It's called Hungry Jack's. Like, there's a man named Jack, and he's hungry. So he opened a restaurant, and now the restaurant belongs to him. It's called Hungry Jack's.
Hungry Jack apostrophe, yes. Hungry Jack's.
Yes,
okay.
Yeah.
That truly is a lawless wasteland down there, mate.
It is pretty good, isn't it? The reason that it's called Hungry Jack's... Can we... No, we can't attack with the fairy jewelers because of the Steeple Creeper. The reason it's called Hungry Jack's, I think, is because there was already a registered business...
Well, there must be something like that, right? It has to be something like that.
It's like the Saboteurs, the band. There's already a band
equipment called this. Our opponent here opted to give this flying and then rethought their decision and didn't block.
It's really good. It's really
good. On second thoughts, I've changed my mind.
No.
Joke's on you. We have Senate Griffins for days.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the Senate is in session.
We're actually in a pretty commanding position here.
Yeah, you know, all these flyers are putting us in good stead.
We can attack with everything next turn. They kind of have to trade for one of these and go to two.
I think if our opponent is interested in overcosted activated abilities, just for the BMs, they should be continuing to activate that hybrid.
But they should be adapting constantly, yeah.
Yes, I think
always
so.
Always
adapt. That would send us a message. Always have an exit strategy.
And this 3-6 dude keeping us... this 3-6 is a little bit of a lifesaver on the ground. So is this...
Yeah, yeah.
This Sky Tether really saved us a beating from the Rubble Belt Recluse.
Yeah, it's not so. Yeah, he's actually living up to his name this time. The recluse, like Rubberbelt recluse, attacking each turn. That's not the typical behavior of a recluse. A recluse is like, oh, I think I'll just stay at home, watch Netflix.
So the sensible thing to do is to block one of these with this.
Well, what right. could they possibly have?
I mean, lots of cards. What are you talking about?
No. They've got nothing. Dennis. Once again, reverse artist. I'm trying to get that one going. I thought that's a good gag, but no one seems to be going for it.
Which gag? I didn't hear you.
The reverse artist's proof.
Where it's just white on the other side?
Is this white on the face rather than on the back?
Too many words, too many syllables.
I think it's really good.
Okay. They've gotten gun shy.
Yep. Cold feet.
Our opponent cannot make their mind up in this game.
No. Maybe they're playing. Maybe this is a Pokemon type situation.
Holding a good old fashioned island in hand.
I think this is a Twitch plays Pokemon situation.
You think? Or they're just group thinking.
I think so. Yeah, I think it's a bunch of it's a hive mind attempt at playing Magic the Gathering colon arena.
I think I'm gonna send both of these in.
Sure. What could possibly go wrong?
Like again? Oh no!
Whoa!
Oh boy!
Now we're doing a bit of.
What? How is that an option? I did this, and then let me have all attackers again.
Did you press spacebar?
No.
That is weird. I don't know what's going on there.
I have to do an action replay on that. That was weird.
I don't know what happened there. There's no attack
all.
Because
once I've declared one, the attack all button is no longer an option.
No, that's right.
My opponent kind of has to block here with something, right? Because like we could have a trick that kills them.
Let's see. Our opponent has been pretty loosey-goosey with a lot of their decisions here.
Opted not to.
All right.
We do just win here unless we die this turn.
Unless we lose, we win. What's the adapt cost on the Skitterial?
3.
Cost 3 mana.
Yeah, 2 in the blue, make it a 5/5.
A bargain. A bargain at twice the price.
Mm.
It is actually pretty.
I sure realize it's killed a man in the art.
Oh, we're on some like Obra Dinn type stuff here.
What is
Look
this?
Look at that.
Act of treason. Now. Now you're thinking with portals. Okay. Let's see if that kills us.
Oh no. Now they have the aerial superiority.
Okay. Let's should have seen that coming. But all the cards are on the table here, pardon the pun. Yep. So if we can just survive here, we win.
It seems like it. Man, this adaptation has really taken...
Why is it making me listen to this noise for really so long?
The cauldron is really on the boil there, huh?
All right, let's do that. Let's do that. Let's throw this in front of, I don't know, this, I guess. Let's throw this in front of this. Let's throw this. Let's just block everything.
Yep. Seems fine. We lose our duelist there, but whatever. We're just taking 0. They have no cards. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think we even needed to block like that.
Oh, we didn't, but, you know.
But it's about sending a message.
Oh, for sure.
I think our opponents...
They attacked with the -2/1 as well, is my favorite.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think the opponent is sending a very clear message here, and I like it. Giving us a chance to make a mistake. But yep, no, realizing that this one, I think, as they say, Denis, in the biz, is in the bag.
Yeah, chalk another one up for the good guys.
Yeah. Let's send a very clear message to them as well. Oh, the opponent taking it all as well. I like that.
Mm. Yes. Right, we won a game with this deck, which I was not expecting.
No. Come on, Denis. You got to believe.
All right.
Get ready for game 3.
Deck's perfect. No changes.
Yep. Yeah, it won us. It got 100% win rate. Apart from the one that we lost. If you discount that as an anomaly.
Which I would. I would call that within the margin of error. You're not going to the old Magic Fest Sydney in 2 weeks' time, are you, Riley?
Unfortunately, I'm not.
You're on the wrong side of the country, right?
Well, no. Sydney's actually just up the road. It's only 800 kilometres away, 850 kilometres away. So it's very close.
That's quite far.
No, it's very neat. It's just nearby. But no, unfortunately, I'm actually going hot air ballooning with my family because it's my sister's 21st birthday.
That is the worst excuse I've ever heard in my entire life.
Are you kidding? I'm going hot air ballooning.
I'm going hot air ballooning. Just tell me you have to wash your hair, mate, and call it a day.
I've got to rearrange my sock drawer. I will send you pictures. I'm going hot air ballooning in the Yarra Valley. It's going to be so sick.
Send pictures. I demand you send pictures. I demand an Instagram live stream of you hot air ballooning.
My sister doesn't even know what's happening. I hope she's not watching this stream.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Maybe I could take the hot air balloon from Melbourne to Sydney. That's actually not a bad suggestion.
Arrive in style at the GP?
Yeah. Just crash through the roof in my hot air balloon.
Oh.
Yeah, exactly. No, it's going to be great. It's going to be really good. But yeah, you know, my sister just thinks it's like a little getaway, like a little sort of family, you know, we're sort of going away, just going to hang out.
Little does she know you're going to murder her by pushing her out of a hot air balloon.
I'm definitely not going to do that, Denis.
Is this how you propose to Megan, your girlfriend? Is this the
yes at text? My sister's birthday?
Well, you seem like a really everything has to be about you all the time kind of guy. That seems right up your
alley. I certainly am. Oh, yeah. And also, you know, I'm all about value. This is a straight up 2-for-1. I get my sister's birthday knocked out. Free, and,
exactly.
Yeah.
How many chicken nuggets is saving the old expense on the hot air balloon worth?
Yeah, see, that's a good point. All right. Might have to go down to the soup. Might get a ring pop.
We'll join them. Ooh, yeah, perfect.
That's no good. All right.
I'm going to keep this.
Okay. Yeah, it has neither of the colors that we need for a Twilight Panther activation, but that's good.
Show me that planes on. Ooh. All right, better luck even good every time. Here it comes.
Here we go. Come on, one time.
Nice.
Yep. That's what we wanted.
Hold.
One time.
Ooh. Nope. This is going to be a short one.
Going to go out with a whimper rather than a bang, Denis?
Oh boy, that's a lot of damage. Okay.
Yep. Staple Creeper is a very aggressive creature.
Four is a bit... Okay.
Okay, all right. Still in it.
Our plane's here and we can just sky tether it, I guess. That's something.
Yeah, block it all with right, escape by if we have to.
Nah, we'll just...
Come on. Land. Man, they are just curving
nice.
Out here.
Nice. Right on time, baby.
Right on time. So what do you want to do? You want to use one mana just to sky tether it?
No, well, this actually also stops 4 damage as well.
Yeah, I think it's... Yeah.
And then we can put a Sentinel's Mark on it, which makes it block everything and also gains us 3 life.
All right. Give us a look at Sentinel's Mark again. Yeah, that seems good. All right.
If our opponent kills us, though, with like a Savage Smash, that's... We're dead. It's all over.
It's all over Red Rover.
No Savage
but how
Smash.
Could they? How could they possibly have it? How could they possibly have it? How could they possibly have it?
Got a 2. That stings. Okay.
Yep. So 3 lethal creatures and... we're dead. Unfortunately. We are dead. Alright, well. We fought bravely, Denis.
We did fight bravely, you're not
and
wrong.
At the end of the day, that's the real victory.
Okay. For some all reason, right. It still gave you a progress towards this. Did you see that?
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we won a game.
I didn't know it did that.
Yeah, we did. We won one of the individual games.
I didn't know that counted.
Oh, well, I'm not surprised that it does. I don't play a lot of best of 3 on Arena.
Mm-hmm. Well, normal ranked draft is not out. Just yet. Reliquary Terror coming up against Kravost. Riley, can we make it safe to the other side of the crevasse here?
we're gonna try to get our pitons out, our rope and pitons.
Pitons. Come on.
You're so ready to put this Exorius Guild game into play.
What? Any of you out there who have seen me play Paper Magic, I play basically like that in paper.
Yeah, whirling.
Oh, get in there.
Your turn. My turn. You finished.
You done?
My go.
You good? Yeah. Yep. It is definitely, my swift play is definitely part of my strategy. I try to dazzle my opponent with my speed.
Oh, no. We're just playing against the same guy again.
Maybe. Let's say go.
Again, no black source for our Twilight Panther. Little 1-mana 1/2.
Yeah, but there's 2 of these bad boys and a single Orzhov Gilgate in the deck to hold it all together.
That's all you need.
I might slambind this.
Yeah.
Just to do something, yeah.
Just to feel like you're playing a little bit of Magic the Gathering.
Yeah.
Take -2.
The muted noise it does when it hits you for negative damage. It's a pop, put.
one of the my favorite like rules reminder texts. I don't know where I read it. I don't know if it's in the NPR or wherever it is, right? But it does say that if a creature has negative power, you don't gain life.
Of course not, yeah.
It does specifically talk about that.
Pow, pow, pow.
What is this engineer even doing?
Let's find out. This engineer, in this case, might make this a 2/6, which would be pretty annoying. No, spiraling some growth.
I'm very jealous. Man, that card's so good.
Oh, what? No.
I hate that.
I do hate that. Thanks, I hate it.
Thanks. I hate it. Man, that's a real stinker. In our four Senate Griffin deck, the old Mammoth Spider.
Thankfully, we took one out.
Man, and Steeple Creeple as well.
We can't even...
Steeple Creeple. Our steeples are remaining heavily creepled. We can attack with the Senate Griffin.
Yeah, I guess this is a 5/5. That's something, right?
I know. No, it's only a tapped, isn't it? Not. I thought it was attacking or blocking for the summary judgment, but obviously not, because you can cast as a sorcery.
That just eats that, so...
All right.
Pass with the summary judgment and zap probably one of these and pump, and then also adapt this.
Yep. Man, Skitterreel is really impressive.
Scuttle Gator. No.
Entering the arena, Scuttle Gator.
Stop. What? That's a weird attack, isn't it?
That's an odd attack. All right, we'll just take it and kill it with a summary judgment.
Yeah, I agree.
So what are the component parts of a Scuttle Gator? Turtle?
Crocodile.
Man, they love their crabs.
Crab, turtle, crocodile, yeah.
It's like whenever I'm cooking, it takes a lot for me to not put a lot of pesto into whatever I'm cooking.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the Simic are the same with crabs. They're just like, oh, just put a bit of crab in there.
Still can't get past this.
No, the gator remains unscuttled.
Steadfast.
Yep. So which part is missing out there? I think the turtle is like in Shark to Crab, right? All of the creatures are involved in the name. Whereas here, I mean, the turtle. Turtles don't scuttle, for sure. Oh my goodness.
The thing that's being left behind in the name in Scuttlegator, dude, is the alligator. This thing's a crocodile.
No, the gator.
Those are different animals, mate.
Yeah, those are different animals. Yeah, it should be Scuttledile.
We can trade for one of these. And so we shall!
And so we shall, yep. Man, a real stinker for us here today, Denis.
Yeah, this has not gone according to plan.
I mean, but the power of numbers was on our side.
Yeah. Frankie Numbers has failed us. Oh, boy.
Oh, no.
Oof.
Yucko. Oof.
We have drafted a deck according to Frank Carson's pick order, and it is letting us down spectacularly.
It is letting us down.
It's almost you're supposed to only use that for pack one, pick one, and not follow it to a letter for the entire draft. Well,
look, I didn't read the whole article. I just saw a list of cards and followed it blindly.
Oh, boy, he's scuttling on.
And now he's scuttling over.
Take nine?
Yep.
Because our only out is to draw a Gilgate for this.
Yep. Denis, how are you so good at this game?
Riley! Oh,
how are you
baby.
So good at this game?
Oh, baby! Now he's got to not die to like any other myriad of threats, by the way, but that's
fine. Yep. No, we're going to do it here. And the attack's so aggressive.
No, we're dead.
Yeah, I don't think that's the right way to play this one out, my friend.
We're dead. We're just dead.
Dead to a slight gust of wind in that case.
Mm.
All right, come on.
Show me what you got.
What do they got? This massive Scuttle Gator is a real problem. Oh, no. Does that help?
That's not that bad at all.
No, because, yeah, they can't send the Creeple into the steeple.
No, it was odd.
I guess they didn't want the afterlife? I don't know. Oh, they can? They can Creeple with
the
steeple.
Well, they can, but we just block.
Yes. This,
We just do this.
Yes.
It's an awfully loud noise, I won't lie. Ah, well, we can't even cast that, but we can cast this. And we're going to get our money's worth out of this Twilight Panther.
Oh, yes, this Twilight Panther has had its annual performance review, and I've sat down and had some stern words with it. Very pleased to see that it's lifting its game. Well, that's a stinker.
That's also potentially a problem.
Potentially. All right. So the gator probably doesn't attack here.
I mean, I have to imagine it doesn't. Oh, no, forcing the issue.
Okay. All right. That's fine. We'll take the trade. We're actually kind of happy to do that because it means we can cast the Watchful Giant.
Yeah, yeah.
Although we do need an answer to this Eremunculus.
What? No. No.
What? They've got something?
What trickery is this?
How can they have something, Denis? You're so ready. You're so ready to respond.
Sure am.
No. Come on. We're not territory.
There is another cat in the deck, Riley, so maybe we're okay.
Man, our opponent taking the sweet time with his play, enjoying every moment of it.
Oh, Riley, okay. I didn't realize we had the Guildgate.
Oh, we got him.
Oh,
We got him. Scuttle no more.
This thing looks like it has flying, which is sad.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Yeah.
I think we have to prying eyes here to try to find a flyer.
Okay. Well, you can do that, mate. You can do that during their turn.
Yeah, but if we draw a land, we'll be able to play it.
Okay, we can play it. Do it now.
Well, we found out a whole myriad of things.
Well, now we can actually deal with the Eremunculus as well, so you're really smart. You're actually very, very smart.
We probably don't need both of these. Okay, well, we don't... Gosh, what do we lose here?
We want to end the game quickly. We want to end the game as quick as possible. So we're definitely keeping the Senate Griffin.
So we're losing this then. And I guess this.
Yeah, it seems weird, but yes.
I figured that out like a champ, mate.
Maybe that was very bad, but we've already got some beef on the board with the Skitter Eel.
If we draw a land, we can actually just play both of these next turn.
Yeah. I think like we just want to be as aggressive as we can be here. Okay, well, that's fine.
A new angle of attack, Riley.
Oh, mate, and we helped him as well.
I would have liked that.
Oh, man. All right. Well, drawing three planes in a row would have been a little bit of a beating here.
This is not flying anymore, though, so it's, you know, fine. Okay. Let's play this, I think.
Yep. And then we can activate
the... adapt this, yeah.
Skitter Eel. Get in there with the eel, mate. It's time for the eel to skitter on. Skitter on down the country road.
I mean, they can just block it with this.
Yeah, and then we kill it.
Okay.
I don't know, maybe that's very bad, but...
We have to end the game at some stage, you're right.
We have to end the game at some stage, and... I mean, we can just pick apart all of their little Wolskis here.
Okay.
I guess they can attack with both of them. No, they're both of their creatures. That seems very bad.
That's very bad. We just eat this. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
All right. Dennis, they say there's no such thing as a free lunch, but it looks like our opponent is proving us wrong here.
Feeling generous for sure.
Yep.
I mean, whatever. Let's just... Ooh, fly boy!
Yep. Got a +1/+1 counter on it. Two of them, in fact. Double flying in the stratosphere.
That's a two-turn clock.
It is indeed.
Riley, I think we turned this one around.
We did turn this one around, Dennis.
We have turned this bus around.
Well, we've done a 16-point turn on a narrow laneway.
Ooh, that's a big frog, though.
That is a galloping Lizarog. All right.
So, I mean, they're just dead. They're just dead in the air, though.
They're just dead to the flyers.
Yes!
We did it. A well-deserved victory, Denis. If you have a look at Adelaide on a map, they've got like the downtown area, like the CBD, right? And it's just surrounded by a ring of parklands.
I think I might keep this and build this an incredibly resolute watchdog with the Sentinels bar.
The town planners had a lot of fun designing that city, I think. But yeah, we're gonna upgrade our little doggo here, are we?
Into a 2/6. It's pretty frustrating to get through.
Yeah, it is indeed.
As is drawing this with no islands in your hand.
No blue sources there.
Oh, there we go. Now we're cooking.
Okay, that's good. Now we got the stove on the boil.
As a friend of mine would say, now we're sucking diesel.
That's a very graphic way to put it there. Man, how there's just our steeples are so thoroughly crept.
You know what? Let's just get a 2/6 in there, I think.
You just want to get a 2/6 in there?
Yeah, let's just pass. If he attacks,
surely we want this. Surely we want the scaling spy. Or I guess if they attack here, then okay. If they attack, then the sentinels might.
I think they will attack. I think our opponent does attack here.
Mm-hmm. Yep. All right. flying. Well, I mean, that's okay. That's their whole turn.
Yeah. Very cautious of them to do that, though.
I think it's... Yeah. I mean, if they've got nothing better to do.
But let's just play the Sphinx this turn as well.
Yep.
Which I think we do.
Mm-hmm,
or
I
do
agree.
We Sky Tap? No,
no. No, just play the Sphinx. Much better use if I manage to do that. And then if we put the Sentinel's Mark on the Sphinx and attack next turn, that's huge. Got double Vigilance.
That's true. Vigilance does stack, which means that it hits them and also gains us the life twice. That's how that works, right? That's run the numbers on that correctly.
Yep, yep. That's one interpretation of double Vigilance for sure.
Okay.
I like how response to that was almost identical.
Okay.
Okay.
Easy attack there. I think we do main phase Sentinels mark this, though.
I agree. Yeah. Gain 5 life. What are they going to do? Man, that is a cool graphic. The Azorius. Man, I'm obviously a rusted on Azorius mage. Very unhappy with the direction the guild is taking under the leadership of Dobby.
Unhappy.
Very unhappy.
Interesting.
Well, all of a sudden we're playing spells in our main phase. That's not the Azorius that I grew up with.
Right.
We're supporting Nicol Bolas. Also not the Azorius.
That's obviously, that's pretty questionable.
Very questionable indeed, Denis. I'm not a fan.
I may defect.
Well, I was thinking Gruul because I play a lot of Scapeshift in Modern, but they're also on the side of Nicol Bolas.
We just built a Sarah Angel here, mate.
Yeah.
It's pretty strong.
Sarah Angel Plus. Sarah Angel 2.0.
6-3-3, bro.
Yep, not great. I don't know. Who's your guild? Which guild are you?
Oh, is it?
Let me guess. All the way. Is it? Yeah, okay, yeah.
I didn't even close to let you guess there, I'm sorry.
I think it was very obvious. You're an Izzet man through and through.
Yeah, that comes across?
I think so, yeah. Yep. You have a, like, just even in your personality, there's a good cross-section of, like, impulsiveness and not recklessness, but sort of, you know, abandon, I guess, with some of the decisions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm definitely a start the car and see what happens kind of guy.
Yep, but also very very quick and calculating as well. There's a lot of blue in you as well, I think.
Don't do any of these things. Stop reading all my cards. I hate when they do that. It's so invasive.
Maybe Simic, actually.
Simic's a close second for you.
Yeah, maybe I'll jump ship to Simic.
Simic are cool.
I really like ramp spells. I don't like all these silly creatures, but I like ramp spells. Oh, no, this is very bad.
Rather annoying. Although, if opponent just starts to come in with this, we do get to eat it with the Arrester Zeal.
Okay, alright, yep.
Let's do it. It's a freebie.
Yeah, it's just a Doomblade. Yep, little Siege Mastodon.
Hum, nom, 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 nom.
A couple of canine steroids there for our Resolute Watchdog.
You want to bounce anything? No.
No, we can get some value off of that, bounce spell later.
I'm going to Sky Tether this, I think, though.
Yeah? Okay, that seems fine.
Yeah. That's a little proactive of me, but we'll see.
Maybe Simic. I'll talk to the Combine and see what they say.
See if they can convince you.
Yeah, see if they can bring me in, you know. Alright, this is a good card. I feel like I'm going to play a lot of this card in the coming Standard season.
Mm. And they hit another Steeple Creeper. These guys are just all over the place. Lazy with Steeple Creasers.
We need some pest control up in the Basilica. And a Jaya Engineer.
Mm. Well, this seems pretty easy. Let's take to the skies.
Get in there.
Let's play a Skatewing Spy.
It's looking pretty good.
This is looking very good.
It's looking pretty good.
Yeah, well, we actually have lethal next turn if we just bounce this.
The Creeple Steeper.
Yeah.
The Kronkle Bonkle.
Or that, for that matter.
Yeah, that seems like a better bounce, to be honest.
I also get to eat the Creeple Steeper. Creeple Steeper. With a Fairy Duelist effect.
The Cripple Dirple. The Smirkle Burkle.
Yeah. Let's get this out of here.
Oh, draw a card. Oh.
Look at that.
I do really like those glyphs, though. Look at that effect, is really cool. We've come a long way from Raid.
Mmm.
Alright, get in there.
I mean, the dog also lets us do this, to be honest. I forgot this doesn't have flying, is what I did, really.
Can we adapt?
No, because it costs 6.
Oh, no. So you trade...
Oh, well, now... That's curious. That was a weird...
You got him running scared, Dennis.
Should definitely not do this. That's crazy.
You got him running scared.
Okay.
All right. Okay, block like this, kill the creature. Oh, double block in case he got a trick. Oh, concede. Yeah, concede. I'll concede. Cool.
Oh, you're right. We went 2-0, and that counted as 2 wins for your...
Nice.
Your weekly tracker. Wow.
Yep, very good. I love it.
Let's keep the gravy train rolling.
It's not gravy train, is it, really? What is on this train?
What's a disappointing sauce? Just ketchup?
No, it's not disappointing because it's always good. Like barbecue sauce is sometimes really annoying.
Non-Heinz ketchup.
Nah, I mean, come on. How picky are you? If I gave you a blind taste test, you would not be able to pick the Heinz tomato sauce.
I absolutely would.
Call. Absolutely not.
No way, man. Are you crazy? You're off your... Oh, my God.
So how many sauces could you pick it out of a lineup from?
5.
But that is... I was going to give you 1 in 3.
No way.
You could pick Heinz tomato sauce out of a lineup of 5?
When is the next time I'm seeing you? Is it...
When is the next time? Oh, Cleveland? In Cleveland, yeah.
Bring some sauces, mate.
That is... Okay, I'll give you like 2%.
That's crazy.
Well, no, that doesn't make any sense at all. I'll give you 20%.
Yeah.
No, you're so bad at this game that you lose 18% equity because you're going to pick the wrong one.
No. I mean, that's still trades, but...
It's fine.
It felt worse than it was. Main board, though.
All right, are you gonna do it blindfolded?
Oh yeah, I'll do blindfolded.
The blindfold taste test.
Yeah, for sure.
Mate, you have not. You got Buckley's chance, mate.
Who's Buckley? Is he Buckley an expert sauce taster?
William Buckley was a convict. I think I explained this. He was a convict who was transported to Victoria,
mm-hmm.
And he escaped the penal colony. And he made friends with the locals, nice. The indigenous people out in the bush, right? But people didn't know this when they escaped and he ran away into the bush. They're like, oh, he's got no chance. You got no chance at all of surviving. You got Buckley's chance. Actually, wait, no. It doesn't work in this situation because he did survive. He ended up going and making friends with a bunch of indigenous
Buckley's
people.
Buckley's chance, against all the odds, I win. Perfect, sounds great. Line it up.
Okay, all right, you don't have Buckley's chance.
I'll bet you $20. 20 US dollars.
20, a crisp Tubman.
A Tubman. Is that who's on the dollar?
I think it's going to be anyway. It's got Andrew Jackson on at the moment. Yeah. Who is by all accounts a nasty boy.
Don't block the soul read.
Well, they lose a card either way, right?
Yeah, they saw the line.
They saw the line. All right, you want to bet $20?
I think I do. I'm gonna.
Who's providing the sauce though? Do I have to? Am I the sauce?
I'll bring the Heinz.
Well, no. If there's anyone that you're bringing, it's not the Heinz, because you could have laced that with like something to make it.
Well, I'm concerned that American Heinz ketchup does not taste like the Heinz ketchup that I know and love.
Well, we can do it in Dublin then.
We're not doing it live on the Pro Tour, on the Mythic Championship stream.
Sorry, I'll just butt in real quick while Huey Jensen beats down Paul Reitzel.
Yeah, we got a lot of options here. I don't know what the...
Oh, our opponent very helpfully reminded... Oh, we skipped over something really important here. Not only is our opponent reminding us that it's our turn here, look at their name.
Angstlord, yeah.
Angstlord. That's
Angstlord
great.
Angstlord is right. I'm going to play the Santa Griffin.
Is this because you want to hit a land, or...?
I want to hit a land, yeah. I want to be able to play this and some... ooh, that's actually not bad either. I'm actually going to hold on to that, I think.
Okay. Mm.
Yeah.
I trust your judgment. We're not under a lot of pressure here. The Sphinx is also very bad against the opposing Griffin.
Ooh, attack, please.
All right.
This is my only chance to kill this, so.
Yep.
Because of that pesky dog. Bloke.
Yeah, that didn't seem great from the opponent.
No, let's get that Sphinx down then.
All right. And what's the adapt cost on the on our friend Scuttle, mate?
3. No. Oh, this is 8.
Yeah, okay. Basically a million.
Yeah. Legally, this thing's for 1 million.
Get in there.
Get in there.
4 damage.
It's no joke. Nothing to sniff at, mate. Nothing to sniff at. I think we play a Skitterial and a Twilight Panther here. Because, of course, we just chump the Scuttlegator with a Minister of Obligation, which has insanely has Afterlife 2.
Yeah, it has 2 ghosts inside it. We got a double Casper situation.
That's a little bit annoying, but Sphinx still pushes through.
No. Easy game. That is more get rid of that career. Yeah, definitely attack. Our Duelist as well is playing around something like Arrest of Zeal here.
Mm-hmm.
Nope, no need. Just get in there. Man, Vigilance. So good.
No joke. No joke.
So what ability does the courier have?
It can give itself Vigilance.
Okay, that's it. Yep. Little owl. That's a tough owl as well. Judge's Familiar has come a long way.
I think it's evasive. I think that's what that is. It's like how your armor class... No,
it's got 4 toughness, mate. Like, that is it.
But it's like how your armor class in D&D takes into account how hard you are to hit.
Oh, so you think that toughness comes from dex?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, I can see that.
I'm just going to continue to send in this old space here, mate.
Our opponent has to do something.
Oh.
Doing lat pulldowns here. Go. Yep. Well, 4 toughness not going to be enough to save you here, little Owski. Oh, we're trying to get... Oh, my goodness.
That's just buying time in a different way.
I mean, that's just, yeah, sacrifice a creature, gain 4 life. I don't love that. If that's the position they're in.
Mm. Remember now, we've got another gate and an Orzhov Guildgate in our deck to get this lad through as well.
Oh, yeah. Yep, get in there.
We're also getting to the point where it might be profitable to just turn everything sideways.
We're not far off it. An Azorius Locket is not what our opponent wants here. All right. How are we looking? I haven't crunched the numbers.
Well, it's on 11, so probably it's still no good. So,
probably. We don't actually need to count.
We could have, no.
Counting is for nerds.
That's demonstrably true.
Yeah.
I wonder if our opponent wants to crack this for cards or wants to try to get to 8 mana. Which I mean, they're at now.
This getting the Scuttlegator to attack just does nothing against our Ministrant of Obligation.
Hmm. That's pretty good.
Oh, Graspy.
We can get it with the Duelist, but...
Okay. Buffers their life total a little as well here.
Yeah,
that's
helps
fine.
Their cause for sure.
So you just attack with the Sphinx, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Level up our Skitter Eel.
Be careful to miss a free one of those.
All right.
Ooh.
Oh, Gateway Snake. Hello.
Sneaky.
Sneak in, my friend. Sneak on. Man, that's cool. Draw a card. I felt a little Ophidian here. A little snaky boy.
Ooh.
So what's the flavor here? The Duelist is...
Jabs in line, I think.
Just goes and... Oh,
okay,
boo.
I mean, that's fine, I guess. It got a card.
Okay.
And we're getting this for free here. So.
We're getting a lot of value out of that Fairy Duelist here. Going and poking the Thrall in the eye. It just doesn't make sense. Doesn't the Thrall have like a mask on?
Yes. It's got eye holes. Yeah. You can poke through those eye holes.
Man, Seb McKinnon. What an absolute banger of a set he had.
Mm.
So not only that card, the Thrall, but also Bedevil. Oh, sorry, Bed Evil.
Bed Evil, yeah.
Bed Evil and Growth Spiral.
Yeah, he was Growth Spiral as well. That's cool.
Yeah, he's done a lot of work. He's really swung for the fences.
They're getting very close to turning everything sideways here.
It's looking good. It's looking good, Denis.
Here come the cards.
Yep.
My opponent's running scared here. Another flyer lets them put a stop on the Sphinx, but...
Okay, so now they can activate the Scuttle Gator.
Do they opt?
Oh, Bankrupt in Blood also.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting. Ooh, that's pretty good.
What's this? What is this, Denis?
It's a Spire, really.
Chuck our eel up into the sky.
Yeah, do it. Yeah.
Yeah, this doesn't end well for our opponent.
No, it certainly doesn't. It certainly doesn't.
Yeah, I love it.
Deck's perfect, front and back.
Deck's perfect. No possible... It's funny how, like, when you draft a deck, you're like, oh, well, let's see how this goes, and then you lose game. And so then for the... Or, like, match one. And then for the rest of the draft, you're kind of like, man, my deck really sucks. I'm so lucky to be winning. Whereas if you win the first game, you're like, oh, this is unbeatable.
I don't know if you're the quite this is unbeatable. I do understand. I do get the whole, like... It's a pleasant surprise from here on out if you win, yeah.
Well, it just sort of, you know, it sets the tone for the rest of your adventure.
Well, also in the traditional draft queues, we're now a single loss away from being out. So the tension is at an all-time high.
Yeah. Maximum enjoyment here. Mm. Are we also playing against the other stinkers? Is that the other thing?
Because we lost the first one.
Yeah, they may have changed. I think they changed the algorithm.
Keep...
One of my favorite things to do when playing games generally is to blame algorithms. I don't really understand what algorithms are, but I know to blame them. For example, when I'm playing Overwatch and I don't get play of the game with, you know, my sweet, D.Va bomb or whatever, I go, oh, algorithm.
Just the algorithm, mate.
It's just the algorithm. I never play D.Va. I'd like to make that very clear. I'm a support main, usually Moira or Mercy, so I never get plays of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Although, actually, Moira can get it done sometimes.
The soul read. Oh well, they're on the line. What do they hit? They hit three lands, they hit two lands. This thing.
Jokes on them. Didn't even want them. Didn't even want those cards.
This card is so good.
It took you three times, but we got there. Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah, I took the scenic run on that one.
I got a question for you, Dennis.
Hit me.
Which of those creatures depicted in the art of Swirling Torrent, which is being put on the top of the library, and which is returning to the hand?
This is going to the hand. This is going to the top of the library. He is going under that swirl. There's no way he's staying above a water van. How do you feel about bouncing this? The answer is bad. I'm going to play this.
Okay. Well, thank you for asking, Dennis. I've given it a lot of consideration. What is the difference between a ministrant and a minister? I'm going to even see if a ministrant is a thing.
It must be something. Your money's on no.
Yeah, ministrant. There's minestrone soup. Oh, no. A ministrant is one who ministers.
Interesting. So it's just sort of like a gender-neutral term.
I guess so. I mean, minister is too. You can have male or female ministers.
I really want to draw the card. I really want to buy a little bit of tempo. I want to see that slick animation again.
Oh, it's archaic. According to Merriam-Webster, it's an archaic take on it.
Out of use.
Yep. An olden day minister.
Right, we can get the Sphinx and the Griffin down.
You know, this is a minister who's still using a fax machine, Dennis.
Oh, a very archaic.
This is a minister that is summoned to perform ministrations with a beeper.
With a beeper. No, I want lands. I have enough gas. I want to be able to cast this eventually. I'm actually okay just sending this in if they want to trade this for this.
I feel like I've got another one, but it's not coming together.
Another joke about being obsolete.
Yeah, I feel like I've got another one, but it's not really working.
Well, this minister just put together his Friendster page kind of thing.
This is a minister who flies in a Zeppelin rather than a plane. No, no.
That one, you lost confidence that one so fast you didn't finish
saying it. It didn't work out. It didn't come together.
Let's see if our opponent has the sick block on this.
I mean, you block every time. Yeah.
Ooh,
yeah,
they thought of everything.
Oh, well, let's play the Sphinx. We can start getting busy.
It makes me look a right mug with this one in my hand, though.
What do you mean?
Because it also can't attack through.
Oh, right. Okay, sure. That poor Griffin having to carry around a chest armor like that.
Yeah, it's not really fair, is it?
No, it's very heavy. So, offering the trade here, or we're gonna watchdog.
Rex is gonna take to the skies, mate. That's what's gonna happen.
we're gonna hack some traffic lights here.
Ooh, and get in for four. I like that.
All right. Okay.
Cool. Let's play another one. Probably put a land on top for this.
And Fido is still ready to...
Fido's got his jumping boots on.
Yep.
Boots of Spring Heel Jack over here.
Boots of Spring Heel Jack. Oh man, I miss Oblivion.
Yeah.
I saw a mud crab the other day.
Have you heard of the High Elves?
Stop! You've violated the law.
Violated the law. Your stolen goods are now forfeit.
Then pay with your blood.
Just some of the absolute classic lines from Oblivion.
Get it, get him, Rex. Go, boy, go.
Go, mate. Take to the skies. Fly.
Go, mate. No, the flicker. I guess that's kind of annoying.
Yeah.
Traded it for a different card, though. So, I mean, it's not the end of the world.
No, it's still annoying, but that's all right.
Yeah.
That's all right. Oh, prying eyes next turn. Are you gonna main phase it again?
No. I'm gonna attack with this. Oh no! My opponent really running the mill plan here. We're down to
cool
16 cards.
We're helping them out as well by drawing four.
Our only out.
Oh no!
Cats.
Oh no! They're just cheap squires now.
Stupid right. Cats. Oh jeez, I'm gonna not play that.
Oh jeez.
Five. Oh man.
Oh jeez.
I don't really want to attack the Skittering Eel into that. So let's just do this.
Alright. Yeah, it seems good. They can block, but that's alright.
And they do.
The soft hexproof ability of the Sphinx, I think, is pretty unimpressive.
It's pretty forgettable, to be honest. Flying Vigilance are really the keywords you're looking for there.
Yep.
No!
It's
scuppered our aerial plans for sure. We're kind of running out of big hitters in our deck, to be honest, to like push through this board state.
Yeah, a little bit actually. I mean, we still have about 10 Senate Griffins though, luckily.
Oh boy.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
Keep the guild gates for the gateway sneak, I guess.
Man. That is No, we still got business.
We
still got business. Yeah, we still got some business.
What business?
We got the 3/2s. We got more of them. We got Watchtower Giant or whatever it is, Watchful Giant. This is a giant in a long trench coat that, you know, approaches you and says, "Hey, you want to buy a watch?" Because he's full of watches. Okay, never mind. Tough crowd today.
Sorry, I'm just trying to figure out how to get us out of this damn.
No, it's all good. No, thanks.
I mean, that's just trades there, yeah. That's annoying. Trades for this. Like, we have to.
Death touch any destructible.
Like, there's nothing else to be done. We have to start whittling away at their board somehow.
Yep. Oh, well. Play the giant. And just hope.
I suppose. I mean, we can always put the... Do we still have that... The Sky Tether in? Yeah, we can Sky Tether this and just try to beat them to death with the Griffin.
That seems fine. We do have another Griffin as well. I think we've got other flyers.
Well, there's a Griffin.
Okay. Show me Sky Tether.
Hey!
Easy.
I'm going to say go. I don't really want to risk losing this to combo trick. Now that it's our only plan.
Yep, we can. So we sky tether the courier.
Oh my god!
The thought of everything, Dennis. Never didn't have it.
We still get in for three.
Yep. It's a long and winding road. A long and winding sky path.
Oh god. It's a 6-turn clock, which is barely faster than us just drawing to death, by the way.
Oh jeez, yeah, we're on 8 cards. So Gateway Sneak is now actually pretty bad.
I mean, it also deals the damage, which could be something. If they kill this... What? Oh, no!
So blocks for days here.
Well, he double blocks one of them and eats it.
Yeah, it's very bad.
Oh, no. That's two demoralizing.
Oh, Dennis, no!
It's two... What's the out, Riley?
Something. What could have been... What could we have drawn? Skatewing Spy?
He milled that. Oh, sorry, I put that on bottom when we scryed.
Oh no. Do we have more business? Do we play the 7-drop? I think we play the 7-drop.
I'm okay with that, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's better.
And lose one of these stupid cats.
Yeah.
No,
yeah,
that's Sky Tether.
Yeah.
That's one of my best cards.
Sky Tether is important. Sky Tether is pivotal.
Get that cat out of there, though.
Yeah. All right, Ajani.
Disaster.
Ajani's going to switch to
Gideon.
Yep.
Okay, sure.
All right.
It's slow, but I think it's better than the average six on the play.
Agree.
It's just very hard to turn away a hand that's lands and spells, you know.
I put it down to six as well. That's good. Excuse me. Bit of a yawn. It's been an early start for me.
It's a late night for me. It's coming upon 10 o'clock here.
Oh, mate.
Okay. No gas.
All right.
I mean, gas, but nothing castable.
The Bowser is still chugging away here.
Oh, jeez. We've done this dance before.
Yes, we recognize this. Okay.
Show me an island.
That perfect ooh, banana baby. Base. Okay. All right. That's good.
Now we can attack Arrestor Zeal and play the Sphinx of New Prague.
Oh, what a turn we're going to have. What a turn we're going to have next turn.
I'm suspicious. Do we just Sky Tether this? No, I'm suspicious, but I'm not an idiot. Come at me. Because we can always just also Sentinel's Mark if it's just a trick that our opponent has.
I feel like they're just going to... Yeah, we're just going to block and they're going to bounce off each other here. All right. I don't know about that, actually. They might have something here.
Yeah, but we have this as well.
Ah, right.
I mean, them flickering, it's fine.
Like that's, okay, yeah, because it can't
block. That's a wash.
Yeah, well, yeah. It's just nothing happens. Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. That was just like a little counterspell. All right. And now we've got our old Sphinxy here.
Mm-hmm.
Build your own Baneslayer.
Mm.
All right. Good. This is good. Get in there. Or do you want to? You want to?
I'm going to tether it.
Okay. Do you want a Sentinel's Mark as well, main phase?
No, I want to attack first. And if they have the deals 3 damage to it, I want to save something with the Sentinel's Mark.
Okay.
This specifically.
Okay. Yeah, I guess the life total like isn't huge. Yeah. Oh.
I mean, we just throw this on.
Yep. I mean, it's not even that great a block.
No, all they're doing is... You got it. They just misclicked. Yeah. That's all that is.
Yep. Good.
I'm just gonna get this thing out of the way. I hate it so
Maybe,
much.
Maybe. I don't know. That could have been real a real, you know, assertion of dominance there.
Maybe.
Don't be too quick to dismiss it as a misclick. That's a powerful play.
Sending a message to your opponent.
Give my creature visual.
Okay, Scuttlegate is fine. I thought we were going to have a Swirling Torrent and I was going to be an angry boy.
No. No, it's us who has the Swirling Torrent here.
I want to find a land, and I did.
Well done.
And my opponent's just dead next turn.
Can I congratulations you on your perfect play, Denis, here?
Yeah, thank you very much. I think that's just it. You got it.
That's not going to do it.
Dead on board, though.
You are in a little position we like to call dead on board, Frando. Yep.
Yes.
And they saw it. Easy. Never didn't have it.
Hmm.
You're a wizard, Denis. You're a powerful sorcerer.
And I've earned us a booster. Apparently. And a Tetsuko.
My sixth copy of the Ultimate Fighter.
Shouldn't you have gotten gems for that, then? Not for ICR.
No. It's an uncommon, too.
Let's do one more.
One more?
One more. Well, if it's a loss, it's going to be one more, whether we like it or not.
Yeah. All right, Khan.
I would love to play first.
Indonesia.
I would love to keep this hand.
Wow, a reasonable hand. So, are you going to play the Azorius Guildgate, or are you going to keep it for old Sneaky?
Well, first of all, I can play the dog, so I'm going to play the planes.
Yeah, I don't think we play. I think we hold the depending on what happens. But
if we hit turn 3 when we have a land, we're going to play the damn thing. But
Yeah. All right, Fido, well. Go. If you had a dog, what would you call it, Denis? I wasn't actually asking to get your answer. I was asking you to share, so I could share mine. So while you're thinking, I'll do that. One that really does not is people wasting human names on pets.
Like if I call my dog Sebastian.
Yeah, exactly. That's odd. That was the name of the dog that my parents had before they had me.
But before they had you, by which, does that mean you're the new dog?
Oh, no. So before they had me, they had a dog called Sebastian, right? Little Cocker Spaniel. And then when I moved out, within like 2 weeks, they got a dog.
Weird.
Yep. So I was, it's not so much that like, I was the stand-in for, 18 years. And then they went back to their preferred method of, canine.
Because what you said was, Sebastian was the name of the dog my parents had before me, Riley, who was also a dog, which is what that sounded like.
Oh, right. You thought I was including myself in the subset of dogs. Denis.
Yeah.
M. Night Shyamalan twist ending. I've been a dog all along.
I wouldn't be surprised for even a second. Our opponent saw the lion playing the lamb before, which means we can't, unfortunately, summary judgment this in attacks. Which is annoying.
Oh, we'll because the
because they can just adapt it.
But I think because so for example, I'll give you a rundown of the names of the cats that I've had.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, Assassin.
Cool name.
Good name. Number two, very for a brief period, a Paladin.
Paladin.
Paladin, like the D&D class.
Right.
And then
these are all classes so far.
The most recent cat, which is now I had to sort of give to some friends when I moved to Germany, Longsword.
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 What do you call him for short?
Longsword.
You can't shorten full name every time.
You can't. You can't shorten Longsword. Then it's a short sword, Denis.
Oh, great. This got double flying.
Oh, mate, it's on the Karman line. It's 100 kilometers in the air.
No blocks.
All right, take three.
Mm-hmm. Let's play.
I think just murder
it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna judge it. Yeah, harshly.
Summary judgment. No, not even a trial, Denis.
Mm-mm. Need to dig for an answer to this though. Perfect.
Apparently, we don't need to dig at all.
No, that's the card I had in mind when I thought of that as well. I mean, obviously, something like Sky Tether works. Maybe everyone just forgets and doesn't block here. It's possible. I didn't say it was probable, but it was possible.
Nope. All right.
Next turn, though, if they play another creature, or heaven forbid, heavens to Betsy, if they invest a bunch of mana into this and we swirling, oh boy.
Oh boy.
I would like to wait to have two targets for it, obviously, but we'll see. They have 6 mana, so kind of in a rough position attacking-wise. We just play this, then we bench this and the creature to play the following turn, get it with everything, draw a card, deal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 you've damage.
Denis, you've gone full beautiful mind.
I'm Kasparov. I'm 13 turns ahead.
Yeah. That's chess is way too hard.
Okay. Surely they're not attacking. That's madness. Yeah, take right. 4. Take 4, attack back for 7, and draw a card. That's crazy.
Yeah.
What are they at?
Yeah.
I was like, oh, sweet. Obviously, we were drawing that. Let's see what else we draw, though.
Yeah, this is looking pretty good. It's looking pretty good here. Oh, another Senate Griffin. The Griffins don't stop.
I'm going to play another Senate Griffin, mate. A cool, easy 9. I'm going to take that as well. A cool, easy 9 in the air up top here.
And so they play a creature. We take 4.
They can't attack here. It's crazy to attack here. This holds off so much damage and on a reasonably low life total.
But why did they attack last turn?
That was a weird attack, yeah. I don't know.
Maybe they attack again.
It's an interesting but unimpactful start to the turn.
Such a good card. Oh my goodness, such a good card. All I want to do for the next like 18 months is play that card in Standard.
You think it's good in Standard?
I hope it is, man.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's seeing play. It's seeing play in some of the, the opening lists and like the Simic aggro lists and whatever else.
Right.
Which aren't really my cup of tea, but I don't know. I want to play like
Our opponents... almost dead on board here. Like, this is crazy.
Do you want a prying eyes to find our Arrest of Zeal and a Plains?
Find our Sky Tether and a Plains.
Yes. That's kind of loose. You going to do it?
I'm doing it. Yeah, oh, no, neither.
Neither.
Oh, boy.
Never lucky. Oh, boy. Right. We'll get rid of the Panther.
Yes, definitely get rid of the panther. And an eel, I guess, I think we get rid of.
Yeah, okay. All right. So why didn't we just swelling tower there?
I thought this was more fun.
Okay. So they block, they go to three.
There's also value of killing our opponent without showing them we have Swirling Torrent.
Yeah, Swirling Torrent in that situation would have won the game, right?
Oh, absolutely. But I
but that's
to
no
try
fun.
And...
That's but no that's fun. No fun. That's no fun. That's not what we're about here.
Oh, we're dead.
Oh, it has...
Oh, God, no!
That's good, because that was on board as well, and like we could have seen it happening as well. There was no information hidden. Oh, what?
Why didn't they attack?
Oh my goodness, this is just a battle of the clowns here.
This is a joke.
I mean, we are throwing custard pies across the big top and missing each other entirely. It is embarrassing. That is very sporting of our opponent being like, I know you should have won last turn. I'm going to let you have it.
How could they know that?
Wow.
What?
Played perfectly. Played perfectly. Got rewarded. Never didn't have it, Denis. We are stone cold masters. We are stone cold masters. I love the flex. I love your like still had all these type flex into their onboard trick. And I love their like, oh no, I better stay back to block because I'm on three. Never mind, I can attack.
Oh my god, I can't believe
what
that.
Is going on? What world do we live in here?
Somebody please clip that. Oh my god.
No, don't clip it. I never want to see that again. I don't want my name attached to this.
Your name is very much attached to this, man.
No, I don't want my name attached to this.
Oh, fair. Here we go.
I play Denis and zero mistakes.
But they
that's
gave
my
it
brand.
Flying. They spent their turn giving it flying and then just
and
didn't
then,
attack.
And it didn't attack. Yep. Oh well.
This is a no.
We cannot cast any judgment on our opponent there. Like we can't say like, oh, what an idiot, they didn't attack for lethal or this sort of stuff.
Perfect. Oh, no. I mean no probably.
Yeah. We don't want the dogs and the cats, no.
Yeah, we'll never hear the end of it.
Okay. Yeah. The gates are open.
Oh boy. Probably should just play a planes in this first now that I think about it.
Nah. Denis, you've never made a mistake in the past.
You know what? I'm going to stop playing gates. In case we draw the gatekeeper boy. And because we have a million lands in our hand.
Yeah. We're flush with lands here. Got great big tracts of land.
Ooh. We've missed out on 1 point of damage already in this game, so the punt counter is strong. Nice.
Okay. The great big tracts of land, mm-hmm. you know, obviously where that comes from—the Monty Python and the Holy Grail bit, right?
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, you know the bit. It's one of my favorite ways to sneak in what would otherwise not be a PG. Rated joke into what should be PG content.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, a 4/4.
Okay. That plays around the Panther marvelously as well, unfortunately.
I mean, we're 1 point ahead of this damage race, though.
Yep. Yep, the Panther got some work. Got in early, the office, got some work. Well, not that early, actually. Did arrive a little bit late.
A little bit late, 9:15.
Yeah, but still, I mean, with its recent performance, I don't know. I'm not sure about renewing the contract of the Twilight Panther, to be honest. We may have to have a stern talking to it. Will you step into my office, please?
No blouts.
All right. What you got cooking? What's up next?
All right, then keep your seat. This blocks that. That's easy. Yep. Ooh-wee. Okay. Nope.
Wrong.
Riley, the cat's got out.
No, leave the cat in the bag.
Well and truly in the bag.
All right. I still don't understand the flavor on this card. The fact that it can kill ghosts somehow gives it death touch. I don't know.
You know what would actually not be a terrible draw here? The Go other on. Cat.
Why is that?
It's just a fine card to draw.
Against the 4/4 we can't block?
No, but just I mentioned because we have the Gilgate man.
Oh, just because it was a Gilgate. Just want to feel like we're not complete idiots. Yeah, yeah, that does make sense.
All right. Oh, right.
Okay.
That's terrible.
It's not that bad.
Uh-huh. Well, now we don't even have to give it death touch.
Yeah, now we don't even give our creature death touch. Our opponent playing around our cards masterfully.
What are you playing now?
Okay. All right. Well, snap lock.
Yeah.
Give it death touch. Give it death touch. Okay, definitely give it death touch.
Oh, we're getting steamrolled here.
Yeah, we are getting rumpadomped here.
And they attack for 10.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm gonna pack it up.
All right. Few too many Landos there. We touched down on Cloud City, and it was just Lando all day.
Very nice reference.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Do you blame Lando for betraying them?
The one thing I'm good at. Pardon?
Do you blame Lando for betraying them to Vader?
Oh, no, not at all, dude. Come on.
Kid to think in the interest of the occupants of Cloud City, you think?
I mean, but... Okay, Darth Vader turns up at your door and says, hey, mate, how are you going? Remember that guy who kind of stole your ship? Not really, but kind of did, almost.
Right.
Like, who rumbled your whole deal when you were, like, you know, when you were Danny Glover and nicking people, like, cheating at Pazark and whatever else? Remember that guy? Mm-hmm. Would you mind handing him over to me? Oh, you would, in exchange for me not absolutely ruining your business here. Cool. All right, no worries.
Well, ruining your business or just killing everybody?
I mean, the two aren't mutually exclusive.
No, I think one of them is, in fact, demonstrably inclusive of the other one, but...
Ooh, no, I don't think... I don't. I mean, I don't fault Lando.
I fault him a little bit.
No.
My favorite bit in that is when they burst into the dining room and Darth Vader's there, and Han just tries to shoot him. He's like, joke's on you, I'll just shoot you.
But think of that. Hey, look, I really... I mean, obviously, I'm a rusted on Star Wars fan as well, and it's...
Oh, boy.
Love everything about it, but this Han sucks. But Han Solo is just one of the best characters.
I love that he's like, Leia, quick, we've got him with his pants down. This is my shot.
I'll just blast him here. He's like an invulnerable Sith Lord, but I'll just get him.
I'll show you who shoots first. What is this? Don't play a thing. Anything but a thing.
Anything but actual business.
Oh, no, Riley. What is it?
It's the rhythm of the wild, Dennis.
This is the rhythm of the... Oh, baby. Okay.
All right.
Maybe we addendum this, give our good boy a lifelink, huh?
Yeah, throw the dog a bone, as it were.
If they play a 4/4 here, the campy block reaches the power... Okay, that's okay. Give it haste. Give it haste. No!
Rough.
I'm just going to make a 2/6 here to be able to do something.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, yeah, it holds off brush strider.
Yeah, just keeps things cooking. Oh, there we go. Now we're talking.
Okay.
Still can't really cast anything except for this.
Still not play anything, yep. All right.
Come at me, broski. I will block, sir.
Yeah.
Get him, fight up.
Oh, what would you call the dog? Sorry, we didn't finish that.
Oh, I don't know. Because
I would call the dog like Thunderbolt or something sick like that.
Something sick like that.
Yeah.
I don't know, like Benji.
Okay. So a more moderate take.
Yeah.
Not like still very much,
but still very much a dog's name.
Gristlebrand.
Yeah, no, not feeling grizzy.
I think Gristlebrand would be really good.
Getting grizzy with it.
Getting grizzy with it, that's good.
Well, F6.
I hope I get to commentate at like a legacy tournament at some point. Or like getting a grizzy with it. Yeah, so it's like, I mean, I just played Modern as well.
Yeah.
Like Goryeo's Vengeance, getting grizzy with it.
Oh, well, they didn't tap it first, which would have been nice to do for no reason.
Yeah, exactly. attack before damage.
Yeah.
Dennis, I have some bad news. I think we're going to lose this game.
I think we are too. I mean, the Griffins trade for these here.
Yes.
And Fixer okay. draws.
All right, you do need to draw an untapped land for that, though, and I would suggest
here
you do
it comes.
Post-haste.
Speaking
Man, Rhythm of the Wild is so good. We're losing this game.
We are certainly losing this game. Galloping Liz Frog. Oh no.
A Lizrog sounds like a rubbish, like a crappy version of the Balrog.
A lizard, right? Oh, good lord!
Oh, wow. Just like that, huh? Hang on, how did it get six? What?
It doubles them.
Oh no. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Oh, beans.
I think we're still dead, actually.
I think here it's just no good. This is a bad... Oh, and Frank Jackson with the slime bind. What a way to go out, Denis. Gosh. What a way to go out.
I'm gonna level with you, though. Using Frank Carson's pick order to a T to draft a deck got us further than I thought it would.